CBSE NCERT Solutions Chapter 5 Arithmetic Progressions Exercise 5.2 Question number 1. The problem is find the missing variable from A, D, N and A, N, where A is the first term of AP, D is the common difference and A, N is the nth term of AP. Before going through the problems, we need to understand that in order to find nth term of any arithmetic sequence, we have formula here, which is an is nth term of AP, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 times d, where a is the first term and d is the common difference of AP, and n is the number of term that which we want to find. For example, if we want to find seventh term, then we will write a 7 equal to a plus 7 here minus 1 times d, common difference here. So, and we will just put the values of first term and common difference here, and we will get the seventh term. So this is just an example here. Now we can move to the real parts here. There are 5 parts in this, and in the first part we are given a equal to 7, d equal to 3, n equal to 8, and we need to find a n, which is the nth term. So n is equal to 8 is given to us, so basically we need to find a 8 here, because n is equal to 8 and we need to find a n. So n is equal to 8, we need to find a 8. So now applying this formula here, a n is equal to a plus n minus 1 times d, which is the nth term of AP, we can put in the values here, and a is equal to 7 here and n is equal to 8 here. So a 8 is equal to a 7 plus n is 8 here minus 1 times d. D is 3 here, so it's equal to 7 plus 7 times 3, so it's equal to 7 plus 21 is equal to 28. So 8th term of this arithmetic sequence is equal to 28, which is the answer here. Now moving to the second part here. In the second part, we are given a equal to minus 18, and d is unknown to us this time, and n is 10, and a n is given to us here equal to 0. Now a n is given 0, and we know that n is equal to 10. It means that a n is 0, which is given to us, and n is equal to 10. It means that a 10 is equal to 0 here. Nth term is given 0 here, and n is equal to 10. It means that the 10th term here is equal to 0 here. So now applying the same formula for the nth term, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 times d, we can say that a 10 is equal to a plus 10 minus 1 times d here. And now we can put the values here. A 10 is given 0 to us, and a is given to us minus 18, and d is unknown. This is minus 18, and 10 minus 1 is 9, and d is unknown here. Now I just need to shuffle the terms in order to find the value of d. I can move this minus 18 to the other side. 18 is equal to 9d. Now d comes up here, 18 divided by 9 equal to 2 here. So common difference here is 2. So that's part number 2. Now moving to part number 3. In part number 3, we are given a is unknown, first term is unknown, d is given equal to minus 3, and n is given 18, and a n is equal to minus 5. So I'll start again with the same thing here. A n is equal to minus 5, and n is given here equal to 18. So a 18 is equal to minus 5 given to us, and a is unknown, and d is equal to minus 3. Now applying the same formula which we used to find nth term of arithmetic progression, is a n is equal to a plus n minus 1 times d. Now here a n is, now putting the value of n here, we can say a 18 is equal to a plus 18 minus 1 times d. D is minus 3, and a 18 is equal to minus 5. So I can put minus 5 equal to a plus 17 times minus 3 here. And now I need to just shuffle the terms in order to find the value of a. So minus 5 is equal to a, 17 times minus 3 is minus 51. So I get here A equal to 51 minus 5 and it's equal to 46. So first term is equal to 46 of this arithmetic progression. Now moving to the fourth part. A is given equal to minus 18.9, D is equal to 2.5, and N is unknown to us, and AN is equal to 3.6 here. AN is equal to 3.6 given here, and N is also unknown to us. Now, applying the same formula again to find the nth term of AP, we have AN equal to A plus N minus 1 times D. Now AN is given, now I can just put the values here. AN is 3.6, A is minus 18.9, plus N is unknown, minus 1 times D, D is 2.5. So here I get 3.6 is equal to minus 18.9, 2.5 times N, minus 2.5. Now I just need to shuffle the terms in order to find the value of N here. I can take all the terms to the left hand side. I brought this 18.9 to the left hand side, and I can also take this 2.5 to the left hand side, and I get 2.5N on the right hand side. So I just need to add these terms now, and they are 18.9, 3.6, 2.5, 9 plus 6 is 15, 15 plus 5 is 20, 8 plus 2 is 10, 10 plus 3 is 13, 13 plus 2 is 15, and 25 here. So I get 25 here. So 25 is equal to 2.5N. So N is equal to 25 divided by 2.5 equal to 10 here. So N is equal to 10, which was unknown and we found it. So that's it about part number 4. Now part number 5. A is given to us 3.5, D is 0, and N is equal to 105. And AN is unknown to us this time. Now applying the same formula which we used to find the nth term of arithmetic progression, A plus N minus 1 times D, A is given to us, it's 3.5, and N is given to us 105 minus 1 times D, D is 0. So anything multiplied by 0 is 0, so this whole term becomes 0, so it's equal to 3.5. So it means, and also putting the value of N here, we will write A 105 equal to 3.5. So that's it for part number 5th also. So that was all about problem number 1, exercise 5.2. In the next video, I'll be covering chapter 5, arithmetic progressions, exercise 5.2, problem number 2. See you guys.